another episode of Cooking with Lawn. And today I have a really special episode for you guys. It's gonna be our Valentine's Day episode, and we are making something so savory, so rich, and so decadent. This is not something you just make for any other ordinary dinner. Tonight we are making lobster and shrimp Alfredo. I am so excited about tonight's dish because I love pasta so much. I can't believe I haven't made this for y'all on the channel yet. So I am so ecstatic. We are about to jump right into this. Tonight's episode is for all my couples out there who want to have like a sexy, intimate date night at home. And this is the perfect meal to be able to make for your spouse. They are going to love it. So I'm going to start out. I have this, I think this is about a 7-ounce lobster tail here that I am going to put in the broiler. But before I do, I want to prepare it to go in the broiler. So what we're going to do is take a pair of kitchen shears and we're going to cut along the back of the lobster tail all the way down just to where the tail end is. Really actually harder to cut than I thought. So then we're gonna open this up here. Just make sure you get all the meat from up under there, because you don't wanna miss out on any of the meat. And this is a little bit sharp, so be careful. Just run your finger up under the lobster tail and separate it from the shell. It's kind of hard to do, but just work with it. All right, now that I separated all my meat, just gonna open up the shell. And then I'm just gonna grab all of that good juicy lobster meat, pull it up, close the shell back up, and we're just gonna place that lobster meat right on top. And that's how you get that beautiful presentation. Make sure you take out the vein. We'll set that aside, this little broken piece. So we're gonna set it just like this, and then I'm gonna go in with a little bit of salt and pepper, because I definitely wanna season it. A little bit of salt and pepper. And then I also have just a little bit of paprika just for color, not really for flavor. I don't want too much. And this is gonna go in for about 7 or 8 minutes, just until the lobster meat is opaque. And then we're gonna take it out and I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do with it next. So I have a pot of water boiling back here. It's been boiling for like a good 13 to 15 minutes. So now I'm gonna add some sea salt to my water. You always wanna season your water. Don't mess up an opportunity to season your pasta. And then I'm gonna add olive oil as well so that the pasta doesn't stick. The type of noodle that we're using today is fettuccine. You can use really whatever noodle you want, but fettuccine, let me show you. Fettuccine is very, very thick, as you can see. It's really gonna sop up that Alfredo sauce, whereas other noodles like spaghetti or even like angel hair, those are just way too thin for such a thick sauce. You really want a noodle that's gonna be able to stand up to the sauce and add more flavor. So I'm just gonna add in that fettuccine, and that'll take about 12 minutes to cook before it gets to al dente. And remember guys, I told you al dente is when your pasta is very tender on the outside but has the slightest bite on the inside, and that's when you know your pasta is ready. I never even mentioned that this Alfredo sauce, we're making this from scratch. I'm not about to pour a container of Alfredo in the pot. I'm showing you how to make it from scratch. So I'm gonna add in a half, I'm gonna add in a half stick of butter and let this melt down a little bit. Oh my God, I did not know my pan was this high. And y'all, I usually don't use the canned garlic stuff, but today I was feeling a little lazy. I didn't feel like chopping up all that garlic, so we're gonna add in some mixed canned garlic. And we're gonna just wait for the garlic to get golden brown. shop. It's really, really easy. It's only a few ingredients. It doesn't take much at all. And I bet after I teach you guys how to make this Alfredo sauce, you're gonna be making it all the time once you see how easy it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of dry white wine. Do not add Moscato in here. Don't add no sweet wine. You need a dry white wine. So I'm gonna just add a few tablespoons of that. I'm gonna turn my flame up so that the alcohol cooks out. You want the flavor, but not the alcohol content. And then while that's cooking down, I'm gonna add a bit of chicken stock. You can add seafood stock if you like. I've tried it with seafood stock before and it doesn't have that much of a difference in flavor. So you can use chicken stock or seafood stock, whatever you have. And I'm gonna just turn my flame up and let this reduce down a little bit. It'll take about 3 to 5 minutes. So as y'all can see, the chicken stock and the wine completely cooked down. It's nice and thick. So now I'm gonna add in the half and half. I have a pint here. Definitely don't use milk. You need the thickness of cream and the thinness of milk, or you can use all heavy cream, whatever you want, but don't use all milk. It'll never thicken up. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be so good. I'm gonna use, let me see. I used just about the entire container. And I'm gonna go ahead and stir this around. I turned my heat back up to be very high because that high heat is what's gonna thicken up the half and half. So while this is thickening, I'm gonna go ahead and add my seasonings. I got some salt and pepper. Got some Obey. And don't forget, you're seasoning this from the ground up. So it may look like it's a lot of seasoning, but remember that cream has no flavor whatsoever. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep stirring. I love the color that Obey gives things. Like, let me actually, I'm gonna switch this out and grab a whisk. And to help our sauce thicken up just a little bit, we're gonna add some Parmesan cheese. I'm gonna just keep whisking that in. Add a little bit more parm. So just continue to whisk your sauce with the high heat on, and eventually the sauce will thicken up. It's gonna take about 7 minutes since I'm using half and half, but if you guys decide to use heavy cream, it'll thicken up in no time. It'll probably thicken up in about 3 minutes. So our sauce has been cooking down. It took like 7 minutes for the sauce to cook down, and you know that your sauce is ready when you're able to coat the back of a spoon, and look. It's coated. So I'm going to add in the shrimp. I have some large peel and devein shrimp here. I like to add my shrimp in raw because that raw shrimp flavor will cook. Well, not the raw shrimp flavor, but the shrimp flavor will cook into the sauce. And because it is a seafood sauce, you want that added layer of flavor. And begin working it around in the sauce. And the sauce is already hot. So as you can see, some of the shrimp are already turning pink, if you guys can tell. I'm getting excited, y'all. My mouth is like legit watering because this looks so good. I can't wait to try it. Our lobster is done. So I just chopped it up a little bit and I'm gonna add it to our sauce. And our pasta is done as well. So I'm just gonna add, it's already like stuck together because of all the starch in the pasta. So I'm gonna just add this in here slowly because you don't want too much pasta and not enough sauce. So I add in a little bit of pasta at a time and mix it up and see if I need to add any more from there. So I'll go ahead and mix this up first. And the sauce will separate the pasta a bit. so you don't have to worry about that. Don't you hate when people make Alfredo and it's just like sticky? It's not supposed to be as thick as macaroni and cheese, y'all. Okay? You can make it a little bit more saucy. So I feel like I need my sauce to break up just a little bit. So I'm gonna add in some more chicken stock. Just add it in the chicken stock. So we're about to try it. I'm so excited. Oh my gosh, I haven't had pasta in so long. Get a little bit of shrimp, a little bit of lobster, and a bunch of this fettuccine. Let's see. Shrimp and some lobster. Y'all. I know I say my food is good every single episode, but this is so bomb. Like, it makes such a difference when you make your own Alfredo sauce versus using that canned stuff, y'all. Get rid of the canned stuff. Make your own Alfredo sauce. I promise you, you can do it. It is so tasty, and that lobster, so tender. Y'all. If you are looking for something to make for your spouse that's gonna really impress them, this is it. It's so good. Serve it up with a glass of wine, set the mood, light some candles, dim your lights, and you will be in for a romantic night. So thank you guys so much for tuning into another episode of Cooking with Lawn. If you recreate this meal on Valentine's Day, as always, upload it onto your social media and use the hashtag CookingWithLawn. I will see you guys next week, same time, same place.